I have been a self-employed software developer for the last 6 years. You may have seen my short videos, my long videos, or my pictures on Instagram. But what does it really look like to be a self-employed software developer? In this video, I'll be bringing you along my day and a day in the life. I'll be showing you some of my highlights and lowlights. Is that even a word? Of my day to really show what a day in my life looks like. It's gonna be a busy day, so let's get started.
Okay, so for today, I'm going to show it hour by hour so that you can get a detailed look into what my day looks like. But first, some context is needed on how I split my day. When I say I am a self-employed software developer, I mean it. My business partners, Lee, Jason, make sure you give them a follow, by the way, and I have been a business called Tomorrow Inc. for a very long time. The SparkNotes version of this is we are an agency that helps businesses with marketing, technology, and production. I have led the development of lots of different applications used by different sectors. That's where most of my experience comes from. My other job, coding with Lewis. You're watching this right now. Okay, back to the timesheet. 6 a.m. So, as you're going to tell, I spend a lot of time sitting. So for my health and to those concerned in the comments, I try and go to the gym every morning. I'm not a self-help influencer, so getting up is really hard, okay? Like really hard. Currently, I'm trying to do a combination of cardio and weightlifting, which I really enjoy, but I really hate getting up early. I'm such a night owl, jeez. This is usually when I get back home from the gym and do all my getting ready tasks like showering, which I'm not going to show you for free, and making my lunch for the day and getting dressed. You know what normal humans do? I promise I code. Now, controversial opinion, but I think the best place for coffee is McDonald's, so I just grab an extra large of one of those and we're good for the morning. All right, 9 a.m. Okay, we're finally at the part where I start doing something programming related. At 9 a.m., I show up at the office where most of our employees work. Excluding Lee, Jason, and I, we have 7 employees. 5 work at the office and 2 remotely. Our office also acts as a co-working space as well. Where I work is in this little nook with myself and 2 other software developers, Jack and Sean. You probably recognize this if you're a fan of my videos. It's also where I work. The other devs and I do a stand-up meeting to discuss our days. Sometimes we do it sitting down. It's just a silly term, isn't it? So, high level, if we had a project needed to be done by a client, we would split them into sprints. Sprints for us is 2-week increments where we try and complete a certain amount of tasks that will be a complete version by the end of that 2 weeks. These tasks are called tickets, like fix bug where email field doesn't accept the @ character, etc. Right now, we're working on an augmented reality project. It's pretty cool. Once we talked about that, we then get right to work. At this point, we usually are fresh out of coffee. I drink it really fast. So I have the crisis of deciding if it's time for another one or not. This is also the point where I open up my calendar to see if I have any meetings. Managing my time efficiently is really important to me, so I'm happy that this video is sponsored by Rise. Rise is an intelligent time tracker that improves your focus and helps you build better work habits. I use Rise to track my time between the different things that I'm doing, like coding, editing, or replying to emails. Outside of that too, Rise reminds you of when it's time to take breaks without needing things like a Pomodoro timer. For programmers specifically, you can use project-based tag to help you segment how your time is spent. If you're a freelancer, that's some paid work you can bill. Or if you're a programmer, this is a good way to tell your project manager that you are spending too much time fixing this pesky bug that they ran into and affects only them. Sorry. The data that Rise collects is both encrypted in transit and at rest, and they don't sell any information that they gather. If you want to try tracking how your day is spent, try Rise for free. The first 1,000 to sign up using my code CODINGWITHLEWIS or the link in the description can get 25% off their first 3 months. Thanks again to Rise for sponsoring this video. Okay, back to my day. I deliberately don't email in the morning because I feel like if I start, I'll get swamped. So instead, I just jump right into the code. So here's what I'm working on while the other devs are working on the AR stuff. We get lots of revisions from clients and lots of miscellaneous places. Email, text, Facebook, LinkedIn. Now we want to get them to fill out the form, and that request is automatically put in our project management system. We could use a no-code tool to do this easily, but in this case specifically, I need to give myself a little coding test with Rust. So here's my plan. Have the form call an endpoint to my Rust server and have it validate the data and then send an HTTP request to the project management system. So simple little project, just a little middleman between two services. This should only take an hour. Famous last words. Well, it didn't take an hour, and I'm still not done yet. The issue with learning a new language is that there are so many pitfalls that can happen, especially going from a heavily typed language like Rust from something like JavaScript or Python. Maybe I'll check this out later, but for now, let's just move on to another task. So for those who aren't in the know-all, I create a new short every single day apart from the weekends. I find a topic, research it, film it, and then edit the day of, usually. If you know, I get a little extra in my videos. I edit with Premiere Pro and Adobe After Effects. I actually love this process of editing because it's a great way to help tell a story, especially under a minute. All right, noon. The edit usually takes between 45 minutes to an hour and 15, but now is the time I usually eat lunch. Now, remember back in the video when I said I didn't do my emails like probably like 10 seconds ago? Now is the time I only respond to the critical emails. I got type 1 diabetes, so I usually give myself a bolus, email for 15 minutes, and then eat my food. I eat my food, post my videos, and then I'm usually back to work. Sometimes I do a stand-up mode to make sure that I'm not sleepy. 1 p.m. Okay, now we're back to work. Something I like doing at this point is checking in with everyone else and see what they're working on. I don't do pair code often, but sometimes it's just interesting to see how other people go about a solution that might have stumped you. Many times. I'm gonna give this Rust program another 30 minutes. Yeah, it took too long and I just need to move on to it tomorrow or something. I'm getting tired of this. So instead, I'm going to work on another project that is in the pipeline. We use the Django framework to quickly build an MVP of the startup we're working on, with a Next.js front end, top secret of course. Rather than doing explicit hacker programmy things, I'm instead going to build an architecture in the cloud. Now, instead of clicking through a bunch of screens in the AWS console, I'm just going to use Terraform so anyone on my team can boot up an architecture fast. I'm not going to give you silly guesses my architecture, but I need to design something like this, but in Terraform. So let's go. I've used Terraform before, so I made really good progress. Got something basic up with our Docker containers, so I'm very happy with the progress. Again, after that whole Rust fiasco, I'm glad that I got a small win. So pat on the back for me. Okay, last hour, I'm gonna go through my emails. Some days are worse than others, but today was just okay. I have about 30 emails I have to respond to. 10 of them are things related to Tomorrow Inc. 14 of them are emails that are newsletters or notifications that help me be a better dev. That's my newsletter, by the way, link in the description. And then 6 of them are like miscellaneous that I'm probably just gonna put off into eternity. Little side note, by the way, emails are such a waste of time, but I always feel extremely productive doing them. If I emailed all day in a suit, I would feel like such a badass. Also, some Slack messages too. Can't forget those. Okay, so between the hours of 9 to 5, it seems like I am a grindaholic. Gary V, whatever. Take into consideration too, all the times I have a small chat, maybe get sidetracked from my research, etc. It's a busy but also somewhat relaxing day in that sense. However, my day is not over. I still have a little bit of coding brain in me. Trust me, there's like 20% juice at most. So I will dedicate this time to working on a bot for a video. This one is the NewsBot, which I hope is open source by now. Once the logic side of my brain starts to fry up, I then get into creative mode. For my videos, I try, keyword try, to stay ahead with my videos. I am somewhat successful. I write down scripts for around 5 shorts and maybe 2 long-term videos. For my open source series, I usually find out about the project, experiment with it, and then write a script down. For how they code it, I usually go to their engineering blogs and am able to learn there. Anything else is just a process of making things easy to understand as possible. Now, I have all the scripts ready. I put my desk into video mode, which actually is hilarious because it's so uncomfortable to actually stand up with. You know, I'm 6'1", but it's still not the best. Usually no one is in the office at this time apart from Lee and the other side of the office, so it's just me, but in the odd occasion, Sean just hangs back and watches me right next to the camera. Some of the fails are embarrassing.
So how did they solve this?
At this point, I am done recording and start transferring the files to my computer. I use a Mac, but the process is similar to any computer. I get the files and upload them to the drive, where either I edit or Will edits all the way over from Manchester.
I do not sound like that.
Manchester. Sorry. I am finally home where I have a meal prep that I eat, or my beautiful fiance makes me some dinner. At this rate, I'm usually really tired, so we just veggie out and watch one of our favorite TV shows or some YouTube videos. This is when I start going to bed. I say start because you know that mentality you have when you want to go to bed but just won't. I don't know if maybe the internet is more entertaining at night. To get proper amount of sleep to go to the gym in the morning, I usually start to pass out around 11:30 or midnight. God, I'm such a boring adult.